What's the dumbest excuse your girlfriend slash boyfriend has used for cheating on you? Remember when we talked about having an open relationship? No, I don't remember that at all. I didn't think you'd find out. We had been together for 8 years, married for 3 months, and had a young child together when this happened. We are no longer married. Edit, I'm 100% sure the kid is mine. I'm her mom, but I appreciate the concern, guys. I caught her cheating on me with someone I knew. Someone I kinda figured she was seeing behind my back, and had brought it up to her before. Her defense was accusing me of being jealous, so apparently I made her do it. Me being right is somehow my fault. I just, what? I only got with you in the first place because my dog died. Wow, thanks. Edit. Lol, I'm glad you're all getting some fun out of my past relationship pain. Justin, for your information, I'm a girl. He cheated on me with another girl. His dog was also a girl. Not anyone I've dated, but a former coworker. She'd cheat on her boyfriend around twice a month, it seemed. She'd go out with a friend to the bars, F some random guy in his car, and then tell us about it at work. Her justification: what am I supposed to do? I'm horny and my boyfriend isn't there. That's his fault. She was a trash person, so I didn't care enough to engage. But one of the older women we worked with asked, well, did you invite him out to the bar with you? Her response: if no, it's a girl's night out. When I caught him, he referred to a poem that I shared with him a few months prior. He said, remember the great blue sky of unspecified desire? Remember when I agreed with that line? He thought we agreed to sleep with other people because poetry. Edit, for everyone asking, here is the poem. How will you know the difficulties of being human if you're always flying off to blue perfection? Where will you plant your grief seeds? We need ground to scrape and hoe, not the sky of unspecified desire. Rumi. Yeah, I still can't see how he got open relationship out this. I've cheated with everyone I've ever been in a relationship with. Why would you not tell me that before we got into a relationship? My ex was the same. He started dating me. Told me he broke up with his ex right before meeting me. She contacted me and told me what was happening. He told me that she didn't understand that they are broken up. She was delusional and thought they were still together. Cheated on me a year later. After we broke up, he tried to say he was sorry and that he has cheated on every girlfriend he had ever had. It wasn't his fault. It took him a year to cheat on me. It only took a few months with everyone else. Like that was going to make me feel better. I got one. She cheated because she thought I didn't care, and when I broke up she was angry that I didn't hit her or shout because it meant I didn't care. Edit, we were around 18. She told me that her father cheated on her mum, which was the ultimate reason for their divorce. She was actually kind of happy since it happened during her prom night while I waited outside per our agreement. Worst part about that was that both our mutual friends chose her after we split up. I was dating this girl for about 6 months when she said her boyfriend was coming back from Afghanistan. She never brought him up because she thought we were keeping it casual. It might ruin the mood, and she didn't think I would mind. Found the guy, told him what happened, and he was cool. Said he figured it was happening anyways, so he wasn't too upset about it. Well, you were looking at porn. It's the same thing. And then after marriage counseling, which she wanted to try to save the marriage, since we had a young child, when she wouldn't stop sleeping around. We may have been in counseling, but that doesn't mean we are together, so it's not cheating. And then I finally filed for divorce. I went away on a field trip with uni for a week. Came back to find out he'd slept with 2 other women. His excuse? I missed you. I was lonely without you and couldn't cope. You shouldn't have left me alone. Ugh, there was so much wrong with that man and that relationship. Well, you said you love and accept me for who I'm with all my flaws. So you also have to accept that I'm sleeping with other women because this is just how I am. No, I guess not. You said you love and accept me for who I'm with all my flaws. Now help me bury this body. He was out with her in her car. I was out with 2 friends in their car. We pull up to a popular parking area up on a hill, a vantage point where people often sit. I notice her car, and knew he was out with her. He had told me his two buddies were also with them. Decide to go to the passenger side window and scare him. He's not in there. He's in the back, with her on top of him. His claim was that he passed out, and she was giving him CPR, because she panicked and thought he had a heart attack. He was 16, in perfect health. Couldn't explain the naked part though, or why his two friends weren't there. Edit. I love that my most upvoted comment is about dogging in a car park. Thanks, Reddit. I wore a condom. Technically, I didn't even touch her. Really, because there's always space between our electrons. We never touch anyone. So how could I have cheated with her? She said she wasn't cheating. I got sent to me a picture of her, nudes, from the guy she was cheating on me with, and he said, "Look familiar." When I confronted her about it, she said those were old pictures, and he was just trying to start shit. I was like, fair enough. Then I realized that the pictures were literally taken in her dorm room, that she had just moved into that year, and I was standing in the same spot that she took them in as I was talking to her, which made me realize. Took me a second to realize that, but yeah, that sucked. Rough time for me on that one. You don't have a job. True. I had been back quote between jobs for about 2 months. That was enough for her to toss out the marriage and sleep with her boss. I was okay with it. She was insane. 2 weeks later, I filed for divorce. 1 week after that, got a job paying double my old salary. Never looked back. I've posted about this before, but when I was in high school, I showed up at my friend's house for a birthday party for one of my other friends, and walked out back to smoke a cigarette. When I walked outside, the girl I was dating was in the pool, topless, legs wrapped around some guy, and playing tonsil hockey with him. I alerted her to my presence, walked back inside, and she followed a few minutes later. When she came in, and I asked her what was going on, her response was, "Well, I called your house and nobody answered. I didn't know where you were, figured you were out cheating on me, so I thought I'd return the favor." I told her, honestly, that I hadn't been home, because my family had gone to dinner at Red Lobster, to celebrate my mom's birthday. She apologized, I laughed, we split up, and I actually found out later I dodged a major bullet. My ex was impotent. He tried to have sex with someone else in case I was the problem. I wasn't. His junk was just broken. It's your fault, you drove me to it. Me. Taking care of our 2 kids, working full time, breadwinner, doing the household chores, so yeah, I was kind of angry slash tired all the time. Him, working in music, going to concerts all the time and sleeping in. Because I gained 5 pounds. Seriously. He thought cancer would make me lose weight, but when I put on some sadness pounds at the beginning, literally 5. Had a doctor appointment earlier that day, he claimed that I became unattractive. The girl gave him herpes, and they are still together. I wish him no ill will, and glad he's happy, but the petty side in me is kinda happy he's gained some weight, and has the herp. What can I say, I'm not a saint. When I was in my early teens, I was actually on the other end. This girl I was seeing already had a boyfriend, but I had absolutely no idea about it. We were seeing each other for a good 8 months or so. I thought everything was going super well. She even came to my aunt's wedding with me. When I was out with a mate at some shops, we bumped into her. She was with another bloke. I approached her, and she just immediately snapped, and said to this guy hasn't left me alone. He keeps harassing me, and trying to F me. What the F? I literally spoke to her 2 days prior to that. I was more confused than angry. Bit of a fight happened, but when cooler heads prevailed, my mate mediated a talk between me and her other boyfriend, and we chatted about what happened. Needless to say, he apologized for attacking me, and I apologized for not being aware. We both had no idea how she kept her secrets for so long. He became a close friend after all that. Turns out they were dating for 2 years, and after he confronted her after our talks, she said, "I was gonna tell you when the time was right." That was her excuse. Lost a girlfriend, but made a pal. Better trade in my book. My ex always had this weird trust and insecurity issues. Although I was always loyal and faithful to her, I always felt something off about her side of things. When I caught her cheating on me several weeks after I proposed to her and she accepted, I gave her one last chance to explain herself as to why she would throw all this away, and her excuse, because we weren't married yet. WTF. And with that I asked for the ring back. Turns out later I found out from her ex that she was cheating on me with him. Although it was hard on me, I'm glad I didn't end up marrying her and having a family, because she would have cheated on me behind my back. I probably would have had to work long hours while she became a stay-at-home mom and not been happy myself in the marriage. I ended up meeting someone months later and marrying that person, who was 100 times better. As for her, she ended up marrying the guy she cheated on me with. Either me catching her in the act of cheating scared her straight, or she got professional help for her problems in life.